That goes to the relatives of these our fallen heroes. But having said that, I've read a lot of things about them, how good they were, how they were stars and all that. They are gone, they are gone. I'm talking about Kesi and Shuaibu. One thing we need to ask ourselves, why do we like to honor the dead? Why do we like to honor people when they are gone? And now we realize, oh, they were stars, they were this, they were that. It's on record that these people were not treated fairly. As far as I'm concerned, maybe Kesi wouldn't have died, including Shuaibu. It's on record that they were being owed salaries. Mr. Speaker, we'll sit down and we'll say beautiful things about them. We'll say nice things about them. But when they were here with us, they were evil. They were not good. They were arrogant. They couldn't do this, they didn't do this, and they did that. So their death should be an eye-opener to all of us and to Nigerians in general. We should begin to honor people when they are alive. We should begin to appreciate people. We should begin to pay people their dues. Somebody took us to World Cup or to Champion League or whatever. I'm not a sports specialist. But I know that they won laurels at a time. And somehow, something happened, they lost. Oh, remove them, kill them. They should be sacked. Sack them, sack them. You've sacked them. Nobody cared where they were living. Nobody cared whether they had accommodation. Nobody cared whether these people are feeding their children or all that. But they have dedicated most of their time to this country. We clap them to the top, we drag them down within minutes. The next second, they are gone. And people are saying, oh, Shuaibu. And people have the face to even go to their families to pay condolence. So, Mr. Speaker, Honorable Colleagues, it's a very sad commentary that we don't love ourselves. Because if we do, when somebody has done well, you pay the person, you eulogize the person, you give the person his dues. If by adventure,
Honorable Colleagues, order.
If by adventure the person didn't do well the next time, you still commend the person. These men, they died. This one heart attack, this one heart attack. What is heart attack? Is it not when somebody is not settled? When you are bored down with people who are supposed to welcome you, people who are supposed to talk with you? Like somebody just joked. You are in a position of authority with Sarin, and you hear a judgment against the person. By the time the person gets turns back, no one single person. Sometimes the person will open his phone and say, oh, there's no service here. There are service, but nobody will call you again because these people are friends of offices. You don't have friends. What you have is people who come up to you just because you are in position. So, Mr. Speaker, Honorable Colleagues, yes, my heart goes to this family. But most importantly, Nigerians should wake up. They should stop doing things that will send our able men to untimely death. People should stop playing politics with professionals. I met Erufai a few months back, and he told me that the houses they promised them when they won the World Cup, as at that particular time, those houses were not given to them. Mr. Speaker, see somebody who went there, brought Lawrence, brought us to limelight. And yet they came back, we made promises and we didn't give them. Some of them are begging for bread. I'm talking for people who are still alive. Some of them, as I speak, they don't eat. Some of those are stars, they are begging for bread, their children are out of school. Will we wait until all of them are dead, then we'll come and immortalize them, change one something to their name? It will be useless. So it's high time that we start taking care of our brothers and sisters when they are alive. No need to cry for a dead person, because once you're dead, it's between you and your God. What will happen to their children? People who are trying to immortalize them, to go back and take care of the people they left behind. They've gone, they left their mothers, they left their sisters, they left their wives, they left their relatives. Let us go back and take care of these people. For adventure, we'll make them rest in perfect peace. Mr. Speaker, I so submit.
Honorable Kiruka summarize all the arguments.